Stock Management System Tutorial with Procedural PHP Part 3. In this tutorial, we will be manage brands functionality which contains add, update, delete, and remove operation. So let's start. First of all, go to brand.php file and at the top of the page we will include the header.php and footer.php file. After that, go to Bootstrap website and copy and paste the breadcrumbs and panel codes into the brand.php file. Inside the panel body we will add two div, giving the class name as a remove message and div action. The remove message div contains the messages of the operation and div action contains the add brand button. We will move the div into the right by calling the pull right bootstrap class value. Now, create a table with following class and ID attributes as table and manage brand table. In table head section we will have brand name, status, and options. The brand name contains the brand information, the status display the availability of the brand and options section to update, remove the brand from the system. We will be using the Bootstrap modal, which are Dalig prompts to minimize the required functionality. To work with this modal, go to the JavaScript section of the Bootstrap, copy and paste the static example of the modal code into the brand.php for 3 times and give each modal ID attributes as a add brand modal, edit brand modal, and remove brand modal respectively.
In Add Button section,
we will add 2 attributes, that is data toggle and data target. In the Add Brand and Edit Brand modal, we will implement the form horizontal of Bootstrap form, and inside the form we will have two input fields, and they are brand name and status. In form of Add Brand modal, create three form attributes, namely ID, action, and method. The value for three attributes are submit brand form, PHP underscore action slash create brand dot PHP, and post. The ID attributes will be used for submitting the form using the AJAX. And the action will redirect to the createBrand.php file to insert the form information into the system. Create a createBrand.php, fetchBrand.php, editBrand.php, and remove brand.php file in the php underscore action and go to the createBrand.php file. The first line of the code includes the core.php file, which contains the database connection and checking the users is logged in. The second code create a array variable to pass the operation messages into the JSON format. After that, the PHP script checks if the form is submitted and creates two variables to hold the brand name and brand status value and insert the information into the system. To see how it works, go the website and we will see the button to add the brand and a table to display the brand information in the system. Click on Add Brand button and enter the brand information. The page will redirect you to the create.php file and displays the operation messages. Now, enter the brand name and status and submit the form. The page will display the successful message and the information should be added into the database. To work with Ajax, first of all, link to the brand.js file which is located at custom folder, and go the brand.js file. After that, create a global variable and initiate the data tables by calling the table's ID.